Hi, welcome along to another video. Links to the articles are in the information section of this video. We'll do some news articles and then get into what was classed as the strange snow from 2013. Firstly then, USA News, bit of a fun article really. Microsoft Flight Simulator, we fly over HARP. There's a picture there, which we'll presume is from Flight Simulator and HARP and isn't just photoshopped and a bit of fun. So a bit more serious. There was, is, an online event, Why Study Solar Radiation Management, a case study in the cost of acquiring new evidence. The talk is going to be given by Eric Winsberg of the University of South Florida. You can see there the organisers from Hyderabad and San Diego. Hyderabad in India, San Diego, University of California, coincidentally. There is a Zoom link on the link. And what's it about? Recently, research into the possibilities of developing solar radiation management and other geoengineering technologies has gained new momentum. Just this year, Cambridge University announced the opening of a Centre for Climate Repair as part of the university's Carbon Neutral Futures Initiative. A recent paper published in Nature gives hope that SRM could confer more benefits than previously thought. But opposition to even conducting research into SRM remains strong. And they're going to use the case study of SRM to develop a framework for thinking about the benefits and costs of acquiring new evidence and for thinking about the conditions under which new evidence could be harmful. Main speakers are from the University College London, Michigan State University, University of Virginia, University of Wisconsin, University of Cambridge, New York University, University of South Florida, and the University of Pittsburgh. On the subject of California, in Time magazine, during fire season in California, breathing feels like a luxury. The Bay Area has long been known as a hub for innovation and creativity, bringing the world products like Twitter and Facebook and Google, but there has been no cloud seeding technology deployed to make it rain, which is unusual for California because they've been at it for about 70 years. Makes you wonder, doesn't it? Via the Business World, Philippines, regional updates. We've covered this before with the 8 cloud seeding missions that were planned. So cloud seeding operations will soon be undertaken to augment the declining water level of Punta Bangun Dam and ensure supply for the irrigation of agricultural lands. But sounding a little bit confused right at the end of the article is there is no urgent need to conduct cloud seeding. In the Manila Times, government sets cloud seeding operations to save crops. So we'll keep an eye on that, see when the date gets set for those operations. The Science Daily, there's a new paper out, September 2020, from the Institute for Advanced Sustainability Studies, Climate Engineering. Modelling projections oversimplify the risks. The focus of the paper lies on the models underpinning IPCC assessment reports, the first port of call for mapping combinations of technologies, alternative pathways of deployment, and climatic impacts. The authors show how modelling of solar radiation management tends towards best case projections. And the rest of it's more about carbon capture and removal. That paper's available for free to read. So that was a little roundup of some recent news from the 11th of March 2013. You might remember some round snow, and you might have seen in various winters or snow wasn't really like snow. So there was a comment on the YouTube channel about how someone was reminded of some strange snow a few years back. And I said, I've got some pictures of that from in the UK. Whether it's the same time or not, it's a different story, but here's the pictures of strange snow. So picture number one, you can already make out, hopefully, in the centre of that picture, a pyramidical piece of shaped snow. There's also some on the left and also in the foreground. That's all in amongst spherical, round shaped snow. So zooming in on the picture, you can clearly see some pyramidical and spherical shapes. So they're quite clear to see, aren't they? There's another zoomed in piece. I'm pretty sure you can see that's a pyramid. Picture number two, there's a whole field of it there. So if you look closely, Pause the video if you need to. You can see clearly they are spherical pieces of snow. This suggests the nucleus and the nuclei are all identical. On the edge there, pyramid and spherical, picture number 3, right at the top, it's in focus. You can see the round ones there, and that's zoomed in a bit more, pretty clear. So then I took some of that snow, added the pH testing drops, that was the colour it went, and that colour relates mostly to ammonia by the looks of it. You can see how green that is. So there you go, that's a roundup of some recent news, along with some visuals for you to be able to keep an eye out for man-made snow in the future. You know what you're looking for. Look after yourselves. Take care. See you on the other side of all these times that we're going through. And see you next time.